What's up, everybody, and welcome back to our crazy Weld Tech Designs channel. I am your host for the next 6 minutes because this one's going to be relatively quick. But I wanted to show you one of these vans that just came in. It does have a little bit of a build out in the inside, which is really cool. I'm going to show you guys that and show you one of the simple things inside the van that I think that I like the most. Just a small little touch. It's like, hey, that's kind of cool. But before we jump onto the inside, I'm going to show you guys what we have going on the outside, what we've done to this, and what we might be able to do for you guys if you have a Ford Econoline. Van, you can tell by the headlights if you didn't know how to tell. So 2008 to 2014, it's going to have like what would be like the Super Duty front end. So that's it. So when we jump into this, but relatively all the suspension components are going to be the same from 1992 to 2014. So if you're looking for a van in those age ranges, we can get you suspension for it, and we can even get you van suspension all the way back to 86. So there was some knowledge thrown down at you. But as we jump in here, you're gonna see an awesome set of Method. These are the NV wheels. I love these wheels. We have them on our work truck, of course, why not? But in bronze, so this is the NV in black. It's gonna have the simulated bead lock on the outside. So this bead lock is not removable. That's a big question that a lot of people ask on the Method wheels, is can you actually remove the bead lock, or does it actually work? And no, it does not. You can remove the bolts if you really wanted to and change those out with something different, a different color, a different style, if you really wanted to get crazy, but you cannot remove that beadlock. But why would you want to? I mean, it looks killer just like this. So just throwing that out there. So as we jump into this, you're gonna see that we have our coil springs, and here's another one with our killer King shocks on the front of this van. We're also gonna have our extended radius arms, and I guess I kind of missed it. If you didn't know the size tire that we run on this kit, this is gonna be a 285/70/17. So that is something really important. You can see that up here in the front, it did get a little bit of trimming just to clear that, so that when this tire does turn, it's going to clear all the way without any issues or rubbing. Before I get away from that, I'll tell you that this is a 17 by 8.5 inch wheel, and it does have 4¾ backspacing or a zero offset. So a lot of information there, guys, if you are looking for wheels. And if you are looking for a set of Methods, let us know, because I will give you a killer price on them. Maybe even the best price out there, who knows? We'll see what I can do for you. So on the front of this, you can see as you jump underneath there, we'll see that we also added a Fox steer, or I'm Fox, losing my mind. A King steering, I'm so used to saying it. A King steering stabilizer as well. So that is another question we get all the time. Well, hey, if I go to King's, do I still have to run the Fox steering stabilizer, or can I go to a King one? And there it is. So there is your King steering stabilizer that is going to work spectacular on your Ford van. So that's gonna sum it up for the front suspension. Let's jump to the back of this and talk about what we did back there. So as we jump to the back of this, another set of these awesome Method wheels. And what I wanna talk to you guys about, two things. So in the back of this, we kept it really simple. We're just running the blocks in the rear till they get the build out, finished out, and then we can go ahead and build them an awesome set of leaf springs for this. So when it still has the stock leaf springs, you're not gonna get the great articulation that you would out of it with our custom springs in the rear of this. Keep in mind that if you are going to do the custom springs in the rear, I always recommend, or at least I'm not gonna say always, there's always a 1%, but I do like running the wheel spacers in the back of this to widen up the back, because when it does articulate, you will or can rub your wheel along your tire on the inner part of your fender well in there. And you definitely don't wanna be popping a wheel or be eating up your tires like I did out at TDS in my Chevy van, where I was just eating up tires because of the articulation. So in the back, we also added a set of King shocks to the rear of this, and that's gonna pretty much sum it up for the suspension work done to it. We did add a killer rear bumper to the back of this, so let's go check that out. All right, so you know me, I like goofing off, blocking out license plates. You know, all you guys out there stalking other guys, who knows what's going on. But I really want to point this out because this is something really cool, is that these are LED lights right here. And what those are going to do is those are going to illuminate your license plates to keep you completely legal. So you're going to have your license plate and it's lighted, lit up. And all of your wiring is going to run through the box and then out through the bottom of it, so it's all going to pivot. Typically, we also put a connector on that, so that way, if you ever do want to just remove your whole tire swing, you can disconnect it, unbolt the license plate, and put it back in the original location on the door, so that way, if you're not running a box or, you know, whatever you want to do. And that, nope, it's not locked. So you can see the wiring just ran up through the box and ran down the backside. Not anything super crazy, and these lights are relatively inexpensive. You can find these on Amazon or eBay. Super inexpensive and they work really good. And if you really want to get crazy, you can also double these up and not even run the bolts in there. If you think, well, hey, I'm never going to move my license plate, I'm always going to run my box, I would tell you to not even drill two extra holes and just use those right there. That's actually what they're intended to do. Just giving you all kinds of options. If you're gonna remove your license plate, then you gotta remove wiring, and that's why we don't do it that way, just in case you were wondering. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna open this thing all up, and you can see that this is gonna be the dual swing setup. And you can see there's that nice little quick, easy connector so that if you wanted to take your whole swing off. The reason I tell you that is some people are like, well, I don't use my box that much, but I'm always wanting access to the rear of this thing. So what it does is it just allows you to have that easy access in and out of your back door without swinging that out of the way, just throwing it out there. I never know what you guys are gonna be doing, and my goal is just to make you guys happy. On the back, you're gonna see another awesome Method wheel on the spare tire mount. And another thing that's really cool that we do, and I would recommend that you guys do, is you can run the same lug nuts that you're running on the rest of your vehicle for your spare lug nuts. That way everything is the same, and it also is going to give you some security so that nobody else walks away with your brand new wheel and tire, because that would suck. So let me open this all the way up. That way you can get a look at that bumper. So I guess my next question for you guys would be, I was considering doing this in a three-phase system so that you could buy just the bumper alone, or then you could add a single swing or a dual swing and the whole swing mechanism would bolt into the bumper. So therefore, if you wanted to buy just a rear bumper without the swings, you could do that, and at a later date you could add the swing. So if that's something of interest to you guys, please comment below in this video and tell me yes, you would love to have that happen, because you want a bumper, you just either can't afford this whole craziness, or maybe you want to do it in stages. So I'm putting that out there for you guys to let me know if that's something you'd like me to do. So while we got both of these swings open, we might as well check out the inside of this thing, because it's pretty cool. So as we jump into the inside of this cargo van, you can see that they have started doing the build out. Again, you're gonna see that really cool, like the tongue and groove roof all in the wood and the recessed LED lighting, which is going to be nice. Looks like they're also running that Max Air fan in here. What I like what they did in the back of this thing is they made this little pocket so that they could still run the TV, and the TV's on a swivel arm, so it could swivel around, or maybe you wanna hang out back, you're doing some tailgating, you want the game going on, and you just wanna be hanging out, you know, back by the back of your van, or who knows, maybe you just want to play video games, you know, I mean, gotta have some fun. So then also what we've done on here, they've done on here, is done this really big drawer, which is going to be really cool. You can obviously got a lot of storage space in there, trying to make sure you're utilizing all of the space in this thing. So let's jump around to the side doors and see what they have going on over there. All right, so as we jump in this, you will see that this thing is not done, but they do have some, put down some insulation. You can also see that they've done like a 3/4 inch that, you know, base for the floor, and then this awesome wood looking laminate. I don't even know what that is. It's just like material, but cool. So, you know, bed, super simple. My bed right here, I'm always sleeping in the dog's bed, you know, the dog house. But, and then it looks like there's going to be another drawer up in the front that then this is going to slide all the way out, so it's going to give you storage on both sides, which is going to be really nice. Always know that you guys want more storage. I'm going to point out one other thing that I do like in this is this has the swivel base in there, and I do recommend, guys, if you're going to do a swivel base or a swivel seat, to do one with the base included, because you'll see over here on that Ford base that the base itself is tapered. So if you run a base on your Ford seats and you turn it around, it kicks the base, it kicks the whole seat at a really uncomfortable angle. So if you're going to do a swivel seat, make sure it's the whole base all in one and not just the swivel mechanism for the seat. So, you know, that's just my two cents. I don't like it, so telling you what I like and don't like. But that's pretty much it for the inside of this. I think it's cool. I look forward to seeing this thing come back with even more stuff done to it and more build out maybe on the inside. Who knows what they're gonna do? They got all kinds of blank slates on both doors. So that's it. That's all I got, guys. Please make sure you guys smash that subscribe button. Give this a big thumbs up. And if you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, I will see you in the next video.